Good morning, everyone. I'm so glad that you could join us this morning. And if you would begin to make your way to the mat and perhaps, take that time for yourself on this little island of mat that you have created and go ahead and lie down and try to relax everything. Your feet should be a little bit wider than your hips, and just let your toes flop open to the four bottom corners of your mat. Your hands at your side, palms up or palms down, whichever feels better in your body. And go ahead and close your eyes and just relax your shoulders totally. Relax your elbows, relax your fingers, just let your hips go. Your knees, everything, let everything just go and settle into quietness. And we'll take a moment to just breathe in silence and notice the air coming in and out of your nose while we do this. Go ahead and bring one hand to your belly and one hand to your heart. And feel the gentle rise and fall of your breath. And on your next exhale, get all of that air out. Your hand on your belly can help you. Slowly seal your lips and slowly inhale all the way up. Imagine you're inhaling past your belly button, your chest, and you can imagine that you're inhaling all the way to the top of your head. And when you get there, pause for a moment and then open your mouth and sigh it out like you're fogging up a mirror. When you get to the bottom of your breath, seal your lips again and inhale slowly all the way to the top. Fog up that mirror. Seal your lips and then inhale slowly. This time, when you get to the top of your breath, keep your lips sealed and hold your breath. And you can use a count, any count that you want, for three breaths or four breaths, or four counts rather. And you can hold your breath. And then when you're ready, exhale, keeping your lips sealed and keeping that growl in the back of your throat, and you'll keep the same count. So if you could exhale one, two, three. And then when you finish exhaling and you get to the bottom, hold your breath again for the same amount of time. And then you will inhale for that same amount of time. And you can use the counting or not. You can estimate whichever seems to work best for you. And we'll take a few rounds of this square breathing on your own. Remember, inhale, holding, exhale, holding, and continue the pattern. When you get to your next exhale, go ahead and come back to your natural breathing, and you can bring your arms back to your side, and you can start to wiggle your fingers and toes. And on your next exhale, inhale, you can bring a nice stretch up above your body, pointing your toes and stretching. And on your next exhale, bring your knees into your chest. You can grab for your shins. You can grab for opposite elbows. You can grab for hands and just take a nice gentle roll on your lower back, massaging your spine. You can inhale and pull your knees in towards your chest. And on the exhale, just relax everything into the mat. Inhale, pull. Exhale, relax. Inhale, pulling. Exhale, relaxing. Inhale, pull. And on your next exhale, send your left leg out long onto the mat, and you can pull your left knee in. And you can either leave your leg on the ground, or for a little extra challenge, you can lift your leg up off the ground. Take your left hand for balance, and you can take your right hand and start to draw circles on the ceiling. And again, your left leg can be on the ground, or for more of a challenge for those abdominals, you can have it lifted a little bit and draw those circles the other way. And then bring that knee back in for a squeeze, and then send your right leg out to meet your left. It might feel a little longer than your right, than your left leg right now. Let's even it up and bring your and inhale your left leg in and give it a nice squeeze. With your right leg, your choice is yours. You can either leave it on the ground or let it hover a few inches above the ground. Take your right hand out for balance, and you can draw some circles on the ceiling. If you have your leg up a little bit, you're going to feel a little bit more of a workout in your abdominals there, a little bit more strength training. And go ahead and send that left leg down to meet the right. And you can take another stretch overhead. And then bring your knees in again. And we're going to come up to standing. And if it works in your spine, you can put your hands behind your thighs and you can rock and roll on your spine. You can come all the way up to your neck and just give yourself a few of these rolls. If it works in your body, that should feel really good up on your shoulders. And we will make our way to standing. Take a nice big stretch up overhead. And you can even take a little back bend here by looking up and kind of going back if that works in your body. If not, just stretch up. Grab for your left wrist and keeping your hips square. Bend to the right. Come up through center, breathing in. Exhaling, grabbing the opposite wrist and bending to the left. Inhale, back to center. Exhale to the right. Inhale back to center. Exhale to the left. Inhale up. And then with a nice bend in your knees, go ahead and nosedive all the way down. Your fingertips might touch the ground or a sofa or a piece of furniture, whatever's near you. And you can let your belly rest on the top of your thighs here and let your head totally go. If it works, grab for opposite elbows and really let your head go and ragdoll. You should feel a nice, let your shoulders totally go. This should be a good, just you should feel that gravity helping your shoulder blades, your head. You can swing gently side by side. If you would like to work on straightening your legs, you can try one at a time or you can straighten. Don't ever lock your knees, but you can either stay bent or you can straighten your legs. Put your arms back down towards the floor and then slowly, as slow as you can, imagine one vertebrae at a time. Come all the way up. Your head will be the last thing to come up. And we will come back up to standing. Might feel good to take another good stretch up overhead. And then let's come down to a seated position. simple cross-legged works. If you would like to have your legs out in front of you, whatever works in your body, simple cross-leg works for me. And you'll go ahead and let's take a nice big stretch up. And then take your left hand onto your right knee, your right hand reaching behind you and looking over your right shoulder. And on the inhale, see if you can turn a little bit more. And on the exhale, you can relax. And let's hold this for a few breaths. On the inhale, you'll twist more. On the exhale, relax. You can close your eyes at any point whenever we're in these poses as well. Inhale and come back to center. And exhale, and we will repeat that on the opposite side. So your right hand to your left knee, your left hand is going to reach behind you and look over your left shoulder. Again, on the inhale, see if you can twist a little more. On the exhale, relax. And come back to center. Next, just simply you can rest your hands on your knees, wherever is comfortable, and go ahead and just send your chin to your chest. You're going to be looking down, keeping your body straight, just your neck and chin. And so you're going to bring your chin as much as it can. You should feel a really great stretch in the back of your neck. We're just going to close our eyes and breathe here for a few moments. Let your head totally go towards your chin. Your neck, your chin is going towards your chest. On your next inhale, take your chin towards your left shoulder, keeping it down. It should feel a good stretch in the right side of your neck. Again, if you ever feel shooting pain, stop what we're doing and go back to something that works in your body. You should feel an edge, but you should never feel shooting pain. When you feel shooting pain, that's your body telling you, no, this is not a good thing for you to do right now. Come back to center, keeping your head down. And go ahead now, and on your next inhale, bring your chin slowly towards your right shoulder, keeping your chin down towards your chest, but to the right. You should feel a really good stretch on the left side of your neck. Come back to center. And let's go ahead and slowly rotate your neck all the way around. You can take it back, making sure you're breathing as you're moving around. And go ahead and take that in the opposite direction. You might feel some snap, crackles, and pop this morning. I know I do. When we come back to center, you can. If you feel a little dizzy, you can always lower your head if you're very dizzy, or sometimes just putting your hand on top of your head can make that motion stop. Next, we'll move to tabletop with your hands underneath your shoulders, your knees underneath your hips. Remember to claw your finger padding so that you're not just on your palm so that you're not putting, that puts too much pressure on your wrists. And go ahead, your feet are flat on the tops of your feet are flat. And go ahead, and we're going to inhale and we're going to lift our head, drop your bottom. I'm sorry, you're lifting your bottom, dropping your belly. And on the exhale, we'll do that scared cat. You can even come up on your fingertips if you want and arch your back and look towards your navel on the exhale. So inhale, drop. Exhale, scared cat. Inhale, drop. Exhale, arch. Take a few of these at your own breath's pace. We'll meet in tabletop, and you can move your right hip to the right and look over your right shoulder for a little bit of a twist there. Come back through center, inhaling and exhaling to the left. And you can take a few more of these stretches. You can do cats and cows. You can wag the dog side to side, anything that feels good. If downward dog is in your practice and you feel like you need that stretch this morning, you can tuck your toes and you can come up and do a little bit of this kind of stretch where you're pushing on your hands and you're walking your feet. Or you can just keep doing cats and cows, whatever works for you, whatever you kind of stretches you feel like you need before we move into our first longer held yin pose. All right, and we will all make our way to seating, to sitting. And we're going to begin. Go ahead, and with your legs out in front of you, take your right leg and bring it over so that your knee is on top of your other knee. And it might be up. You might want to put a pillow here. And you can stay, this can be the pose. If you want to move into the full pose, you can bend your left knee, and then your knees are stacked on top of each other. So it might look like this. It might look like this. It might, you were aiming to get the knees on top of each other, but if that doesn't work in your body, and this is opening hips. So whatever amount you are doing this in your body, it's not what it looks like, it's the stretch that you're getting. So you can have it like this. So the right knee is on top. You can leave your right leg out. We're going to be folding forward, and you can bend this left knee so that it is here. So then your feet are sort of by your side. I'm going to give you a couple of choices of what to do with your arms. If you have shoulder issues, don't do what I'm getting ready to show you. So you can do eagle arms with your left underneath your right and coming around, and then you'll feel a big stretch. Just as good, and what I'm going to do today, because I've had a little shoulder issue, is you can just give yourself a hug where you have your hands. I'm going to put my left arm underneath, so my elbows are stacked here. So I'm just going to put my hands on top of my shoulders like this. And then what I'm going to do is breathe up nice and strong, and I'm going to just gently move forward. And the goal is to get my elbows, past my knees. But if that doesn't work, you might just be like this. It might just look like this. So it's whatever works in your body. I might have to back out of some of what I'm doing with the arms. If the arms don't work for you at all, you're welcome to just put them on the mat, wherever they go. I have to be a little careful still with my left shoulder. All right, so we will move into our first yin. So nice big breath, and then bending forward any amount that works for you.
Thank you.
Don't forget to breathe and make sure you're not holding any tension anywhere. She should just let your head go. Your neck and your shoulders should be relaxed. Everything is just moving towards the ground. Ahead and slowly come up, and you can send your legs out in front of you again. And we're going to repeat that on the other side. So this time, your left leg will cross up over your right. Again, it might be that your pose is going to look something like this. It might be that you can get your knee over your other knee. It might be that you're going to bend your right leg so that your legs are stacked. So this time, the opposite leg is on top. It's fine to have your leg out and be doing the pose like this, or you can have the full pose with your knees stacked like this. If you're taking eagle arms, if that felt good in your arms this time, your right arm will be on the bottom. And this is not going to work for me at all. So you can hug, or you can do like you may have noticed I did as I came out of that hug because it wasn't feeling very good in one of my shoulders. You can just relax your hands down wherever it works. And so we will take a nice big stretch up. And whatever this pose is going to look like for you, we will bend forward and let your head dangle. And whatever that looks like, you should be getting a good stretch in the bottom of your spine. You should feel it in your hips, a good hip opener here, and relax and breathe. Keep breathing. Thank you. Gently come on up, and you can send your legs out in front of you. And let's make our way to our backs for a moment. And bring your feet flat on the mat up near your hips. You might be able to touch the bottoms of your heels with your fingertips and your shoulders sort of underneath you, your hands next to you. And let's lift our hips up off the ground. And challenge yourself and see how high you can lift your hips. It might not be very much, but see if you can lift them up. And this will be a counter stretch of your back in the other direction. And just breathe here. If you need to come out, you can. So you can bring it back down. And then lift your hips. You can challenge yourself and lift them as high as you can. And then we will come back down. And make your way to tabletop. And while we're here, let's go ahead and do that thing where we stretch the tops of our feet. So if you'll tuck your toes under and come back towards your heels as much as you can. It might be that you are like this, feeling that stretch. It might be that you can sit down on your heels or close to your heels. You should feel a good stretch in the tops of your feet. It's uncomfortable, but it shouldn't really be painful. You hold that for a little bit as you can. And then come forward back into tabletop and gently put your feet onto the tops. And we will come back towards our feet again. Again, it might be that you're like this. You can come back and sit on your feet. If it works in your body, go ahead and walk your hands back and you can lift your knees up, and that gets a good stretch on the tops of your feet. Come back up to tabletop, and with your toes touching, bring your knees as wide as the mat, and then come back towards your feet again. We're heading for a child's pose. We're going to do that one where we thread the needle, get a good shoulder stretch here. You might need a pillow here. You might need one here between your feet and your hips because we're going to come down to the mat. So again, if you need a pillow, I'm grabbing a giant bolster here. You can, because we're going to do that coming up and going through. And so you should not be, lying on air. If you come all the way down to the mat, you don't need a pillow. But if you need one, use as many as you need so that your shoulder and head and neck are on something. And we're going to just hold that pose. So again, left hand in the middle, and your right hand up. Your right hand is going to come through that keyhole that you made, and you're going to come down onto your right ear with your arm through. Your left arm can just relax wherever it needs to be. And then try to just settle into the ground and settle into stillness here and breathe. Sure, you're not holding any tension in your shoulders. Totally let that left shoulder even just relax. Your right shoulder's on the ground, but let everything relax into the ground. Make sure that you don't have your tongue on the roof of your mouth, that your jaw is relaxed, that everything is relaxed, and you have your eyes closed and your mouth closed and you're breathing. ahead and unwind and come back up. If you'd like to come up into tabletop and do a couple of gentle cats and cows, or if you feel like you need to stretch your leg gently out behind you. We want to be careful not to do too many jerky moments after we do this, because we want to keep that work that we've done in our body's connective tissue and the fascia steady. So sometimes if I'll be in some classes doing other kinds of exercise and people will be shaking it out. And with this kind of work, we don't want to do that. So we're going to take that on the other side. So again, same thing, toes touching, knees wide. This time your right hand is in the center of your mat. Your left arm will go up and you will come under onto your left shoulder. Again, if you need pillows, make sure that your body is making contact with something. If it's not reaching the ground or it's a little bit up, put a pillow or a block or something there, and we'll take that in the other direction. And then just relax into the mat, settle in and find that sense of stillness. Let that right shoulder go, let just everything just melt into the ground. Imagine that you're melting. Unwind and come up. And again, you can gently stretch as we move into our next pose. If you want to, for a moment, you can put your legs out in front of you. It might feel good to take a little stretch here. We're going to move into that figure four. So again, if you're my favorite way is at the wall. So if you have a wall handy, get your hips up as close to the wall as you can. If you're practicing the middle of the room, you probably know how to by now. So go ahead and send your legs up the wall if you're practicing with me. And that should feel pretty good to straighten your legs out for a moment. If you're on the floor, you have your legs straight. And remember, you're going to be putting your right hand, you're going to be putting your right leg over your left knee. Your right hand will go through the center, and you can bring it like that. If you are at the wall, your arms just get to fully relax on the ground, right leg over your left knee, and start to gently walk that left leg down. You might find as the pose goes that you can just let your left leg slide a little bit more. Your knee should be parallel to the wall, and you'll feel a good stretch in your right hip. And again, if you're doing it the other way, your right elbow will be behind your left, your right elbow will be behind your right knee. So whichever way you're taking the pose, go ahead and relax. Don't forget to breathe and relax. Thank you. Go ahead and unwind. And if you're at the wall, you can send your legs up the wall for a moment. If you're on the ground, just let your legs stretch out. If you feel like stretching with your arms above your head, if you want to just relax here for a moment in between sides, you can. And then we'll go ahead and take our left leg, crossing over our right knee. Again, if you're on the ground, your hand comes through that keyhole and you'll hold. If you're at the wall, just go ahead and start to walk your right leg down the wall. And you should feel a good stretch in your left hip this time. And just let your arms relax.
In the quiet of a shadow, in the corner of a room, darkness moves upon you like a cloud across the moon. You're aware in all the silence of a constant that will turn. Like the windmill left deserted, or the sun forever burned. So don't forget to breathe. Don't forget to breathe. All life is here, no 11th hour reprieve. So don't forget to breathe. Keep your head above water, but don't forget to breathe. And all the suffering that you've witnessed, and the handprints on the wall, they remind you how it's endless, how endlessly you fall. And then the answer that you're seeking, for the question that you found, drives you further to confusion as you lose your sense of ground. So don't forget to breathe. Don't forget to breathe. Where all life is here, no 11th hour reprieve. So don't forget to breathe. Keep your head above water, but don't forget to breathe. Don't forget to breathe. You know you are here, but you find you want to leave. So don't forget to breathe. Just breathe. Just breathe. Just breathe. Just breathe. Just breathe.
ahead and unwind. And if you're on the ground already, you're in a perfect place. If you're at the wall, go ahead and walk down, and you can come through a little mini yogi pose here. You can fetal position. And we're going to make our way back to the middle of the mat on the floor. And go ahead and bring your knees in and arms out wide. I'm going to drop our legs to the right. Again, if your knees don't hit the ground, make sure you use a pillow. If you need a little extra stretch, you can cross your left leg over your right and bring it to the right. And your shoulders should stay on the ground. So if they're popping up, make sure you put something underneath your knees, whichever way you have this. And then you can, if it works in your neck and shoulders, go ahead and turn and look towards your left hand, and then you can close your eyes and breathe. Ahead and unwind and come back to the middle. And then we're going to repeat that on the other side. So with your knees up into your chest, go ahead and start to drop to the left. Again, if you need an extra stretch, you can cross your right leg over. Again, also never let your legs just hang out in the air. Put a pillow under there if you're not meeting the ground. Keep your shoulders on the ground. You should feel a good twist in your right side. And then go ahead and look towards your right hand. This should feel really good stretch, and you should really feel that in your digestive system. It'll help everything move along like it should. And just close your eyes and breathe. Thank you. slowly unwind and come back to center. And then you can take any stretches, or you might want to bring your knees up and you can roll on your back, giving that massage to your back. A really good way to end is with Happy Baby, where it's like that upside down po tabletop pose where your legs are up like you're walking on the ceiling and bent with your knees wide. You can grab for your ankles, or if you can reach your feet, you can grab your feet and you can gently roll here. It might feel good to straighten a leg one at a time just to get a good stretch. And we're going to be settling into final Shavasana. You can take traditional pose like we began. If you really like the way legs up the wall feels, you can go ahead and go back to your wall and put your legs up the wall. I'll take traditional this morning. We're just going to, again, let your feet go and your arms flop out. You can put your hands and you'll relax and go ahead and relax the top of your head. Relax your ears. Relax your jaw. Make sure that your tongue is off the roof of your mouth. Relax your chin. Relax your neck. Relax your shoulders, your elbows, your wrists, your fingers. Relax your belly. Just let it go. You're not holding any muscles there. Relax your hips, your thighs, your knees, your feet, and just let everything melt into the ground. Then close your eyes and breathe in and out through your nose.
Thank you.
ahead and start to wiggle your fingers and toes, and you can take a little bit of a stretch here and breathe. Then bring your knees in, and you can roll over onto your favorite side using your bottom arm as a pillow. Moment to relax totally in this yogi fetal position and just breathe. Welcome to stay here or move back into Shavasana. If you'd like to, you can meet me in a seated position in that simple cross-legged pose. And I'll bring my hands to heart center and I'll say that I bow to all of you. Thank you for practicing with me today. Om Shante, which is peace to all living creatures. And I hope that you can take something of the practice into your day. And I hope that you have a wonderful weekend on this first day of September.
Thanks, Anne. It was great.